I'm Kelsey, and it's time for our weekly spotlight piece. For this week, he's been our president for the past 3 years for the Morgan County Fair, and as he said, he had big shoes to fill. And that's why Marty Marr is in the spotlight. What do you think are some of your greatest accomplishments while you're president?
I don't know, but well, it's such a group effort out there. You know, I've said many times, we've got a great group of people out there that really know how to work well together. And when we make plans to make some changes out there or do anything at all, we all work very well together and get a lot of things done that are hopefully long-term, meaningful changes.
What would you say is one of your favorite memories?
Oh, gosh. There's been several. This year's fair offered quite a few of those. You know, with memories we made there with the Alfano family here this year, losing Mike Mason, what a guy. I really liked working with him out there, and everybody did. He was just a real gift for us out there at the Morgan County Fair. Just being around people like that, it's probably been one of the best, most rewarding parts of being on this board. The other thing, too, is, you know, we kind of got the ball rolling again on the entertainment line out there, and working with Gary Haddon and people like that and everybody on the board, it's just been a really neat experience to see that come back to the fair. As far as enjoying shows the past years, that first one with Tracy Lawrence, just getting it going, you know, and looking out and seeing that crowd light up that night, it was really something to watch. But probably my most favorite was Charlie Daniels. He was a really neat guy. That whole group was great to be around.
I can see your eyes lighting up right now as you're talking about this.
Oh, yeah.
I see the pride.
Yeah, Charlie Daniels was probably one of my favorite shows so far. So you see a lot of things in the 4-H end of it, too, that are quite rewarding to watch, you know, with the families and everything. You know, there's a lot of life lessons taught out there with those programs. You know, you got to, not everybody can get a blue ribbon, but boy, when you see them get those, it's quite rewarding to watch a family really light up and enjoy that sense of accomplishment. And it's just been a real special part of the fair for me to watch, and it's a great tradition out there.
4-H definitely does give kids something to work towards, and a family tradition always helps to strengthen that.
Oh, you bet. It is. It's a great program. It's something that the Fair Board has always tried to keep strong out there, and the 4-H movement in this county is, I think, alive and well.
We're the Midwest. 4-H isn't going anywhere.
Oh, no. They're proud of those clovers, let me tell you.
Thank you so much for all of your work out at the Morgan County Fair, and thank you so much for coming in here today to see me.
You bet. Well, thank you for having us in. It's been fun to be a part of, and I just want to thank the community. Come to our support. I really appreciate that. Every board member does. I want to thank all my fellow board members, too, because they have been really great to work with, and sure proud of what we have been able to accomplish out there.
Marty also wanted to extend a thank you to his wife and family, because without them, he wouldn't be able to do what he's done for the past 3 years. If you're interested in listening to more of the interview, you can check us out at WJVOFM.com.